Salve Maria, I am Brother Ashan and welcome you to our new program of the Marvels of Christendom. So this great personage of whom we thought of discussing with you is none other than the great Saint Joseph Vaz. Saint Joseph Vaz is a Goan saint who was born on 1651, April 21st. So he was born to a very pious, very Catholic family, and from a very small age, he had shown signs of a great holiness, of a great future vocation. As we know, Saint John Bosco, in his life story, we see that he had seen one special dream in which he was revealed about what were the three main pillars of the Christian life. So in this dream, St. John Bosco understood that the three main pillars that were the foundations of the Catholic life were, first of all, the devotion to the Blessed Sacrament, then the devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary, and also thirdly, the devotion to the papacy, the fidelity to the papacy. So if we have a look on the life of St. Joseph Vaz according to this perspective, we see that Saint Joseph Vaz was a model of how a Catholic should lead his life according to these three pillars. So let us observe his life according to these three main pillars. When we look at Saint Joseph Vaz, first of all, we see that he was a model of the devotion to the Blessed Sacrament. From a very small age, he had shown one great zeal towards the sacrament of sacraments. So even when he was small, when everyone was sleeping at his house, he used to go secretly out of his house towards the parish church to pay homage to the Blessed Sacrament. And many times when the church was even locked, the church doors were closed, when he arrived at the church, the doors were miraculously opened and he was able to enter inside and pay his love and homage towards the Blessed Sacrament. Most probably, the angels in heaven were waiting to welcome this little saint. So let us ask Our Lady especially to grant us a great zeal, a part of that zeal that Saint Joseph Vaz himself had towards the Blessed Sacrament. And also we see that Saint Joseph Vaz was a Marian saint. He had one strong devotion towards the Most Holy Virgin. That's why we see that especially on August 5th, 1677, on the feast of Our Lady of Snows, he goes to one church in Sankwal and consecrates himself entirely as a slave of the Most Holy Virgin. He consecrates completely his body, his soul, his intelligence, everything that he possessed. If we observe the history of the church, we see that Saint Louis Marie Grignion de Montfort was a saint who, in his book called The True Devotion to Mary, presented this devotion to the slavery with lot of detail. And he was the great saint that was called to propagate this devotion of slavery throughout the whole world. But why did Providence call Saint Joseph Vaz, who never had a contact with Saint Louis de Montfort, to come to know about this devotion and to practice it himself? Was it because that this great Indian saint was called to do his mission in Sri Lanka, had one great vocation linked to these two countries? Was it because that in front of God, the India and Sri Lanka were very valuable? These are interesting questions to answer. So, as we look at the life of Saint John Joseph Vaz, let us question ourselves, how much have we tried to grow in devotion to Our Lady as Indians or as Sri Lankans? So, let us ask specially the grace of Saint Joseph Vaz to consecrate ourselves entirely as slaves of Mother Mary as he did, so that we may become also Marian saints of the future. So also we see in the life of Saint Joseph Vaz that he was a model of fidelity towards the papacy. When we look at the history of Sri Lanka, we know that the Dutch persecutors, they prohibited the freedom of religion for the Catholics for almost 30 years. So when Saint Joseph Vaz came to know about this, his heart was moved with great pity towards the Catholic Church of Sri Lanka. And immediately he desired to go to Sri Lanka and serve the Catholics there. So he was desiring to serve the Catholics who were in, under the danger of the Dutch persecutors who were against the vicar of Christ. He went and defended the faith of these people and instructed them in the proper faith. So we see his great love that he showed towards the papacy. So also, when we have a look on the life of this saint, we see that he was a model of humility, a great virtue. Dom Shutab, a great monk of the 19th century, in his book, The Soul of the Apostle, in his masterly work, says that humility is a virtue that is compulsory, that is indispensable for an apostle, so that he for his apostolate to be successful. So when we observe Saint Joseph Vaz's life, we see that he was a dispretentious apostle. He was never moved with desire for vain glory, desire for worldly honors, nor he was shaken up by persecutions that he had to face. When we look at his life, we see that he was even in prison, he was tortured, he was humiliated, but he never abandoned his vocation. He never became revolted against God. He never was taken up with pride. He was always calm amidst persecutions. And we see that he was a person who had received many worldly honors also, because we see that the king Narendra Singh was ruling at that time. When he was crowned as the new king of Sri Lanka, after his coronation ceremony, he decided to go in procession in the city of Kandy. So Saint Joseph Vaz was already an elderly person at that time. Saint Joseph Vaz, because of his old age, because of his sickness, he was not able to participate towards the ceremony in the palace. But he thought of having a look of the king and greeting him while the procession passed by near the road. So Saint Joseph Vaz, while he was at the road, the king was passing on the main way, and the king was riding an elephant. And when the king saw Saint Joseph Vaz standing nearby, the king immediately ordered the procession to stop, and he had a small conversation with Saint Joseph Vaz, and asked him about his health, situation of his health. And after he had come to know that Saint Joseph Vaz was doing good, he waited until Saint Joseph Vaz was able to go to his house again, and then afterwards only the king decided to continue his procession ahead. So we see Saint Joseph Vaz was even a person that was esteemed by the king himself, but amidst all these glories, he was not inflated, he was not taken up with pride, he was always calm, and he was only desiring solely, completely, radically for the glory of God. He did everything for the greater glory of God. So we see in Saint Joseph Vaz a great model of the virtue of humility. And also we clearly see that Saint Joseph Vaz, as an apostle of Sri Lanka, labored with lot of enthusiasm, with lot of dedication to reconcile broken families. So Sister Lucia, who saw the Blessed Virgin Mary at Fatima, said that the devil waged its final war especially against the family. So when we have a look on this modern world, we see that this is the institution that is most vulnerable to all sorts of spiritual and psychological dangers. So Saint Joseph Vaz was always a person who tended to reconcile broken families, who tried to bring families together. So once it happened that one lady called Anna Pule had one dispute with her husband, and she had separated from him and was remaining with another house. So Saint Joseph Vaz, when he had met this lady, he continuously counseled this lady counseled her to go and reconcile with the husband. But the lady was obstinate. She never listened to Saint Joseph Vaz's counsel. So as time passed, this lady was taken up by a tumor in her body. So she was taken up by one cancer, and she was very seriously ill. So she was almost at the verge of death. So then Anna Pule, this lady, she remembered the counsel that Saint Joseph Vaz had given to reconcile with the husband, and immediately she decided to go and make peace with her own husband. And after she made peace with her husband, miraculously the sickness passed away and she was cured. So after this, she made one good confession and started to frequent the sacraments with a lot of devotion and to have a good family life. So as Saint Joseph was, we could consider that he is also a patron for our Catholic families in our countries. So let us specially ask Saint Joseph was in this time in which the institution of family has been attacked by many sectors in society, by especially by the world, the flesh and the demon. In this time, let us ask Saint Joseph was to bring peace and harmony in family, to specially to inculcate within our families the habit of prayer, because there's a famous saying that says the family that prays together lives together. So let us ask Saint Joseph was specially to inculcate in our families the life of prayer, especially a devotion to the Holy Rosary, and this devotion to the Holy Rosary in the light of the devotion of slavery to Mother Mary, so that when the families, all the members of our families, may consecrate themselves entirely to Our Lady, so that she may make great saints of the future, great gems, great stars that may shine in the triumph of her Immaculate Heart that would be very nearby, that is going to come in the future. So let us ask this grace specially on this feast of Saint Joseph Vaz through his intercession. So also, we invite you specially to have a look on our videos, and you could subscribe to our channel, and also you could place your commentaries, you can place your likes towards our videos. So we invite you to join with our videos and share these videos with all your friends, all your family members. So may God bless you, and Salve Maria.